Hello. In this video, we're going to be training a language model that can generate text. So, the way this is done is we train a neural net that, given some text input, it will generate the next token or little bit of text that comes after it. And then we can keep feeding this back into itself to generate extended pieces of text. And so I'm going to use the system setup for Argos Translate to model this language model as a translation from a reference piece of text into the next piece of text we want to generate. So for example, say we had the text, the quick brown, we would translate this string into fox. And then we can feed this back into itself. And then generate jumped. And then continue like this. So for data, we're going to use the pile, which is a large language model data set that's released by Eleuther AI. And so the first step is going to be taking this pile data and writing a script that can chop it up into the format here that we need to train our language model. So I have a script that's doing something similar that I'm going to use as a template. Alright, so this is just going to, we're going to be able to pass a file into the script and then run through the data, transform it, and then rewrite it to a new output file. So in this case, what we want to do is take each kind of chunk of text and then again convert it to this form here. So I think we want to limit this to 300 characters. Yeah. Okay, so we're just splitting the data into paragraphs based on new lines, and then picking a random point, and taking the text before that as the source, and the text after that to a space as the target. So we'll try to generate one word at a time. Okay. Okay, so we're completing words here. Yeah, I would say that looks good. I guess one concern is a lot of these are... We might want more of them to open at the start of a word, but I think this is also probably a good thing. Okay. So I have this data downloading. So this is the data from the pile. So this is a JSON line file. I think that's what this JSON-L is. So it's a file where each line is a JSON object with this text attribute. So let's copy this as well. Yeah, so I'm only using one of these. They actually have quite a lot of data here. Okay. So we're not going to use all of this. So head. So we can try to use a million. Okay, so we're just going to wait for this to finish then. Okay, so our parse pile script has run, and as you can see, we've flattened the pile data set into just a plain text file. Okay. So, now we need to run this script to convert our flat text into this source and target data. So, so we ran out of memory, so I'm going to try adding swap space. Pulp notes on how to do this. Okay. Let's run this again. Might need more. Yeah, looks like it. Okay. Okay. Okay, and we'll just let this run. Okay, so this script is finished, which took about an hour. But as we can see, we now have our, this one's weirdly long. But this seems to generally be right, where for each input, we're generating the next little chunk of text. So the next step is to train the model on this data with Argos Train. So I have Argos Train here. And so the entire Argos Train training scripts are built around translating from one source language to one target language. So we're essentially just going to modify this so our source language is still going to be English, but our target language is going to be like inferring the next few characters. So I have this already set up on a VastAI box here. So I've already done this step, which sets up the instance. So we can see here all of the data is stored in this JSON file, so we essentially just need to make our own data package and then add it to this file so that the Argos train script will be able to automatically load it in. So we'll look at one example one here. So this is a data package, which is essentially just a zip archive with the data files in it. So we can just unzip it. And if we look inside this directory, we can see there's the source and target file, which is the data, and some metadata, and then some other information about the data. So we're going to make our own package here by making a directory. And copy our data in. Oops. Okay. Okay, so we finished zipping the data package, and it's here. So now we need to add it to this data index here. So as you can see, we just passed it a URL, so we're going to host it on this machine here. So, So we now have a URL for this. So I'll just change this one here. Okay, so we filled in the metadata, and so we should have, so again, we're modeling this like a translation, but the translation, instead of being from English to French or something like that, we're translating from English to this kind of fake language, which is just saying, infer the next character. Okay, so now we can train our model. So this is the issue. So we can exclude some data if it's too large. But we can just modify that. Okay, there we go. So the Argos Train script is going to download this data from our other server, and then it's going to train a sentence piece tokenizer model and a OpenNMT translation model, and then package this for Argos Translate and CTranslate too. Okay, so our model has finished training, and I've downloaded the package here and installed it with Argos Translate, and then, so you can see we're now using the translate functionality to do inference. So the So this does not seem to be working very well. So it's working reasonably well. It's clearly kind of stuck in a loop here. But there you have it. Inference with Argos Translate.